Welcome back to Hollywood 411. I'm Madison Michelle. Dancing with the Stars is now down to only 8 couples. Last night, Rocco Dispirito could no longer escape elimination. For 2 weeks in a row, the top chef sat under the red light. After the show, Dancing with the Stars professional Edita Slavinska caught up with Rocco and his partner, Karina.
Elimination night is not an easy night, you know, but I guess I'm through my last elimination. That's the good news.
Exactly.
But we have been eliminated every week now, so like I think we got immune to the red light and the heartbeat.
Yeah.
So I think we were actually okay today.
Joining me now is Edita Slavinska to talk about results night. Okay, Edita, we saw you there with Rocco.
Right.
Not a really big surprise that he went home. I mean, he almost went home the week before.
Exactly.
Does this put a lot of pressure on Cloris and Corky because they know now that they were in the bottom two?
I know. This was the first time this season that the production revealed bottom two. Mm-hmm. And I think it does, but it also puts a lot of pressure on other couples because I guess they're going to be revealing this bottom two now.
Right.
And who knows? Okay, so we are sure that Clara's going to might be in danger, mm-hmm. but who else? We have no idea where those couples are placing right now.
Right.
So, and even if you have great scores,
yeah,
you don't know if people are voting,
voting for you.
And
doesn't mean you're popular, right?
Exactly, and that's so important. If you have no votes, you might be voted off even with the best scores. I mean, I don't know if you remember Sabrina Bryan, who was
of course, everyone
a
thought she was going to win or be in the finals, and then there
exactly.
she went home, right? So you got to vote people. We saw you there talking with Rocco, and he may have gotten sent home, but guess what? He got Bruno to do something that no one else had gotten him to do, which is to shake his hips. Tell me your professional opinion of that hip shaking there.
Well,
let's turn the tables on them for one second here.
I know, we hear them criticize our dancing all the time, but here's the thing, Bruno is... Wow. Bruno
he
is
looks
not...
good. Come on. He looks good. He really got down with it there.
Well, he's not a ballroom dancer, but he definitely used to be a dancer, a choreographer.
Yes.
And he can shake it for sure.
Yeah.
I would love to see Bruno doing one of the dances on Dancing with the Stars. Bruno, if you ever look for a partner.
Number one right here. the woman that's been in all of the seasons. The only one. Okay, so let's talk about some favorites. Of course, Brooke and Derek have done so, so well. They've set the bar really high for other people, but also themselves. What do they have to do to continue to stay on top?
You know what? I think that Brooke and Derek, if anything, have to make sure that they shine through with their personality and that they are lovable. Because I don't know how much following they have.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who... would actually vote for them except for their dancing. Like, Cloris Leachman comes with her audience from things that she has done before.
Right.
And
right.
I don't know what kind of following she has.
Well, maybe the mom card, you know, with her having 4 kids,
the mom
and she
card,
does have, and I'm sure that gets
sure.
a lot of votes. So we'll just have to wait and see. Edita, thank you so much
sure.
for coming
thank
on
you
and talking
so much
to
for
us. Always
me.
Great to see you.
Great to see you.
Watch Dancing with the Stars Mondays at 8/7 Central and Tuesdays at 9/8 Central on ABC.